With all the factories around here, well, we're not hurting for business.
Welcome to Clint's. Whatever you need, I'm sure I've got it lying around somewhere. Except mech parts. Don't trade those anymore, so don't waste your time asking. Refurbished a lot of the pieces myself. Gagarin. It was a military town until the end of the colony war. Mechs were our specialty. Everyone always blabbers about Mars making the highest performance machines. But if you needed a system that wouldn't let you down in a pinch, you piloted a Gagarin. But that all dried up when the mechs were banned with the armistice. Now, we've got these new firms coming in. Arkmite, Centauri Mills. Claim they're here to revitalize the city. Which is funny, since their employees refuse to step foot in most of it. Come back soon, eh?
I wonder if there are any mining jobs on Mars these days. I could put up with some dust. Well, different dust.
I don't miss all the extra heat from the old forges, that's for sure.
Not much time to talk. Lots of cargo to sort through today.
United Transport. Efficiency is paramount.
Watch your step. It's easy to take a sudden trip around here.
Chronicles of the Mech Riders. It's a good title. You read it, right? Ah, then let me explain. Action, adventure, heartbreak, humanity at its absolute most raw. Ever since I left the military, I've been thinking about writing chronicles, interviewing other mech pilots about what it was like to experience the war strapped in, and what it's been like for us ex-pilots since mechs were banned. Deployed from 2309 till the fleet got themselves blown to bits 2 years later, and the UC waved the white flag. I was at the Battle of Mars when the Free Stars dropped in to try and blow our industrial output to smithereens. If you've ever visited Cydonia and noticed it's still in one piece, that's my unit's work. Well, in the bold future where the book's done and I don't have to track packages for a living anymore, I'll happily sign your copy. Now, what can I do for you? Sailing across the settled systems, hunting down all these other pilots, it's not going to be cheap. That's why I'm living in scenic Gagarin and not, say, downtown New Atlantis. Every spare credit goes right into the book fund. Of course, I don't exactly mind living in the same town where my mech was built either. But once I've got enough, I'm gone. Roger that.
Secure.
Security is usually good about keeping out strays, but keep your eyes open.
Apparently, the corporate execs are talking about building their own priority catwalks above the city. You been up there? Good luck.
I hate it when the walkways creak.
It's the loudest voices that get the most attention. I doubt most Gagarinites, Gagarinians. Well, the people here don't mind us, is what I'm saying. Some of the other executives and I have been looking to form a town council. Ensure everyone's voices are heard in city matters. The locals would be invited, of course.
End of the colony war hit Gagarin hard. City's just fine.
Looking for a drink? Don't serve anything fancy, so if you're about to ask for wine spritzer or whatever, you can hop right back on your ship to New Atlantis. Well, then make yourself comfortable. And don't start anything, all right? Bottoms up. Don't cook yourself out there.
You one of those corporate drones? Gagarin doesn't want you.
I know a guy who just got a job at the Centauri Mills plant. Won't say what they pay, but his outfits sure have gotten nicer.
Any problems, you should talk to Chief Pretorius.
You been to Clint's recently? He get crushed.
Thank you.
advisable to leave some things behind. I do not understand your attachment to all these objects. Hello, Captain. Good day, Captain. It is foolish to carry so many items on your own. There are a plethora of inorganic materials in this region. Goodbye for now.
Howdy. Looking to buy? Sure does. His full name is Groeneveld Hubble von Houten III, but I call him Grumble for short. He's a grumpy old lizard, so the name fits, but he's also family. Besides selling you stuff, I'm just taking him on a little walk so he can stretch out his little feet. He don't do so well on the ship. He may have six eyes, but he's blinder than a bat in a rock concert. Less is more, I guess. Anyway, soon as he gets on board, he just starts running into things, bumping crates, banging knees, pushing buttons. He uses his tongue to navigate more than anything, so if he licks your boot, you don't mean nothing by it. That's just his way of getting from A to B. What about all this, huh?
Allow me to assist in carrying some supplies.
What the? Contact! Go! Opening fire!
You will not be able to walk at full speed with your pack that full. Thank you.
opening fire.
I am uncertain why you believed conflict with us was advisable. I advise a hasty retreat. It will save. If you require help carrying any items, I will assist. I am picking up faint signs of life in the area.
Thank you.
It would be advisable to leave some things behind. Hello. Let me know if I can be of assistance in the future.